हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ श्री महावीर इंटरनेशनल स्कूल। दिस इज़ योर एसएसटी टीचर, माय नेम इज़ अमिता यादव। टुडे आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस यू द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज़ नॉर्थन माउंटेन्स। मीन्स माउंटेन्स विच आर लोकेटेड इन द नॉर्थ पार्ट ऑफ। So, in this chapter, we will learn more about Northern Mountains, Trans-Himalayan Range, Purvanchal Range, life in the region, and importance of the Himalayas. First, here is gear up exercises given. Read the following clues and answer the question that follows. One picture is also given. Who am I? I am the highest peak of the world. In your GK book, you have already learned about highest peak of the world. Yes, it's Mount Everest. So write down Mount Everest, highest peak of the world. I am located in Nepal. Yes, it is located in Nepal only, highest peak. River Ganga originates here. River Ganga originates from the Gangotri Glacier. Okay, Gangotri Glacier of the Western Himalayas and in the state of Uttarakhand. Let us start with Northern Mountains. The Northern Mountains include the Himalayas. You have already heard about Himalayas and the Karakoram mountain ranges. They stretch across the northern boundary of India. That's why they are called Northern Mountain. The Himalayan range is the highest mountain ranges in the world. The word Himalaya means the abode of snow. Abode means house, home, okay? Because it is covered with snow, it is called the abode of snow, like a house of snow. Yes. Most of the Himalayan peaks remain covered with snow throughout the year. That's why it is called abode of snow. The Himalayan ranges in India stretch from Jammu and Kashmir in the north to Arunachal Pradesh in the northeast. The Himalayas consist of three parallel ranges. The upper range, topper range is the Greater Himalayas. Okay, and it is also has another name, Himadri. The middle part is the Lesser Himalayas, and it is also called Himachal. And the last or the bottom part of Himalayas is the Outer Himalayas. It is called Shivalik. Can you see the map? Yes, map is given. In your book you can see it. Top of Himalaya, sorry, top of map, Karakoram ranges is given. Okay, that is also in Srinagar. See, Manali is a hill station. Nanda Devi is peak. Okay, Mount Everest, it's also a peak. Kanchenjunga, also a peak. They are the Indian part of Himalayas. Darjeeling is also a hill station. It is very famous for tea. Tea is grown in Darjeeling. Okay, Masuri, Shimla, they are all famous. They all are famous hill stations. Several glaciers originate from these mountains. Means many glaciers where it originate from northern mountains. Glacier, what is glacier? Glacier, a persistent body of dense ice which constantly moves under its own weight. That means the part which is made up of ice, okay, which constantly moves under its own weight because of the heat. Many rivers such as Ganga and Yamuna originate from these glaciers. When they melt, many rivers originate from there. Mount Everest, it has the height of 8,850 meters approximately. It is the highest peak of the Himalayas and also the highest peak of the world, which is located in Nepal. Kanchenjunga, 8,586 meters, and Nanda Devi, 7,816 meters, are the prominent important peaks at the Indian part of the Himalayas. Now the first top range of Himalayas is the Greater Himalayas. It is also called Himadri. Being the longest continuous mountain range, it's very long and continuing mountain range, means it's in continuation, dominates a large section of the Himalayas. Himadri is the northmost range, it's top of the range. Its total length is about 2,500 kilometers. It is between 150 kilometers and 400 kilometers wide. It forms a natural boundary between India and China. Okay. It is the highest range with an average altitude of over 6,000 meters. The range is always covered with snow because it is very cool. It is always covered with snow. It receives heavy snowfall. At some places, huge masses of ice move down the mountain slope, which are called glaciers. You know about glaciers? Yes, the huge ice masses. When these glaciers reach the plains, they melt down and flow as rivers. Some of the highest peaks, about 8,000 meters, including Mount Everest and Kanchenjunga, are found here. You can see the picture of Mount Everest and Kanchenjunga here. This range is a region of perpetual snow cover. Perpetual means permanent. They have permanent snow cover. You can see the picture, white part, they are all covered with snow. Thus vegetation like mosses and lichen are found in some parts. Only the vegetation which is grows in cool area. Okay. They are found there. Farming is not possible in this region because it is very cool. They don't have the heat. So, farming is not possible in this area. The next part of Himalaya is the Middle or Lesser Himalayas. That is also called Himachal. The Himachal range is located between Himadri and Shivalik. It extends from west to east with an average altitude of 3,700 meters to 4,500 meters and a width of about 80 kilometers. The Himachal is lower than Himadri, okay, because it is in the middle. This mountain range has some beautiful valleys such as Chamba, Kullu and Kangra. The famous hill stations of Shimla, Mashuri, Nainital, Almora and Darjeeling are located in this range. It's very beautiful area. This range has many hill stations which are very famous all over world. Many tourists come to visit these places. We also go there in our summer vacations. People from the plains visit these hill stations to escape the summer heat. Some important mountain passes. What is mountain pass? The gap between two mountain ranges. It's called mountain pass. Like Rohtang and Zhozi La of Himachal Pradesh are found in this region. The Himachal range has thick forests that are covered with pine, oak, deodar and fir trees. Himachal range has thick forest, okay, as compared to Himadri. Himadri doesn't have forest area, but Himachal has. It has the thick forest covered with pine, oak and deodar and fir trees. The climate of this region is suitable for cultivation and farming is also there suitable in this area. Winters are cold and summers are cool and pleasant. The lower slopes of these ranges have orchards. Tea plantations are found in the eastern part of this range. As I have already told you, Darjeeling is famous for tea plantation. The next topic is the Outer Himalayas. It is also called Shivalik. The name Shivalik is a Sanskrit word which literally means belonging to Lord Shiva. The Shivaliks are the lowest and narrowest range in the entire Himalayan system because it is the lower or bottom part of the Himalayan range, laying at the southern part of the Himadri and the Himachal of the Himachal range. It has an average height of about 900 to 1200 meter and a width of about 10 to 50 kilometer. The Shivaliks rise steeply from the northern plains of India and Pakistan and run parallel to main ranges of the Himalaya. The Shivalik and Himachal ranges are separated by deep and very narrow valleys called dunes. So what are dunes? These are deep and narrow valleys. Example of dune is Dehradun. These slopes are covered with thick forest and a variety of wildlife is found there. Much of the land is used for growing crops like rice, potatoes and maize. So Shivalik is also useful for cultivation also. We can grow some crops there and it also covered with thick forest. Trans-Himalayan Range. The Trans-Himalayan Range lies to the northwest of the Himalaya beyond the river Indus. This region consists of many mountain ranges like Karakoram Range, Pir Panjan Range of the Himalayas, the Jaskar Range and the Kailash Range. K2 or Mount Goodwin Austin, 8611 meter, the second highest peak in the world, is of the Karakoram Range. It is one of the greatest ranges of Asia. It is located to the northwest of the area. Now the next is Purvanchal Range. Pur in Hindi, east side we call Pur. So Purvanchal Range, it is lies along the eastern border of India. These ranges are not very high. They are not very high and means they don't have much height. Their average height is lesser than 3000 meter. They are covered with thick forest, but they also covered with thick forest, many thick
ट्रीज आर देयर. द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न हिल्स इंक्लूड गारो, खासी, जयंतिया, नागा, लोजाई, मिजू हिल्स. द नेक्स्ट मेन पार्ट इज लाइफ इन द रीजन. वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक अबाउट द डिफरेंट रेंजेस ऑफ द हिमालयस, बट हाउ द पीपल लिव देयर. द हिमाद्री रीजन इज वेरी कोल्ड थ्रू आउट द ईयर, मीन्स होल ईयर दे रिमेन ओनली कूल. दिस मेक्स इट वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर पीपल एंड एनिमल्स टू लिव हियर, बिकॉज इन कूल टेम्परेचर वी कांट लिव. मेनी पीपल डाई ऑल्सो इन विंटर्स बिकॉज ऑफ द कोल. जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, पार्ट्स ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश एंड सिक्किम लाई इन दिस रीजन. द वुलर एंड द दल आर द टू फेमस लेक्स इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. हाउस बोट्स एंड शिकारास आर फाउंड हियर. टूरिज्म इज द मेन सोर्स ऑफ इनकम इन दिस रीजन. हिमाद्री इज फेमस फॉर टूरिस्ट बिकॉज मैनी पीपल विजिट देयर इन जम्मू कश्मीर. यू नो अबाउट द जम्मू कश्मीर, दैट इज़ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल प्लेस एंड मैनी पीपल केम फ्रॉम डिफरेंट कंट्रीज टू विजिट दैट प्लेस. एंड हाउस बोट्स एंड शिकारास आर ऑल्सो फेमस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. द पीपल ऑफ द स्टेट कीप कांगरी, अ स्मॉल पॉट विथ बर्निंग कोल. ओके, दे यूज द स्मॉल पॉट विच हैव बर्निंग कोल अंडर देयर लूज आउटर गारमेंट्स टू कीप देमसेल्व्स वार्म सो दैट दे कैन गेट सम हीट टू कीप देम द मेन फेस्टिवल्स सेलिब्रेटेड हेयर आर ईद एंड शिवरात्रि. दैट मीन्स ईद इट्स अ मुस्लिम फेस्टिवल बट इट इज ऑल्सो सेलिब्रेटेड एंड शिवरात्रि विच इज एज हिंदू फेस्टिवल बट पंडित आर ऑल्सो देयर इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड मुस्लिम आर ऑल्सो देयर. दैट्स वाई our India is very beautiful country because it has many religions and many people born over these festivals. They greet each other on their festivals. Sikkim has people belonging to three main tribes, Lepcha, Bhutia and Nepali. Women in Sikkim wear a long skirt called Bakku. Their skirt is known as Bakku. The place is famous for its orchids. So you know about the life of the people of Himadri region. The next is Himachal Range. There are many beautiful stations in the Himachal Range such as Shimla, Dalhousie, Kullu and Manali, which are also the major tourist spots because people go there in their summer vacations. Okay. In the Garhwal and Kumaon regions of Uttarakhand, people are mostly farmers. But in some regions, farmers are also there. They grow some crops here. Mussoorie and Nainital are popular hill stations here. Darjeeling in West Bengal is known for its tea gardens that we already discussed. The climate in this region is suitable for orchards and tea plantations. Rice, maize, barley, fruits and vegetables are also grown here. Animals like sheep and goats are reared in the hills. Means people also rear some animals so they can get some wool or from the sheep and they can also get some milk from these animals. In the Kullu region, people mostly speak Hindi. Like they speak Hindi, Kullu. They speak Hindi. Dashera is the main festival of this region, means Himachal region as the main festival, Dashera. And the last range, or the bottom range of Himalayan range, Thick forest and a variety of wildlife are found in the Shivalik range. It has lot of animals, trees. Slopes of these mountains are used for terrace farming. People use to have the terrace farming there. Cattle rearing is common in the region. Mostly people rear animals for their various purposes. There are many wildlife sanctuaries and national parks in this region. Shivaliks have many national parks and sanctuaries. Rice, potatoes and maize are commonly grown here. Now the importance of the Himalayas, why they are important? If we don't have Himalayas, what can happen to us? Or why they are important? That's a very useful question. First, importance of the Himalaya. High mountain ranges and peaks of the Himalayas act as a barrier against enemies and play an important role in the defense of our country. Like our soldiers protect our country, the Himalayas also protect us from various enemies. It also protects our country from the cold winds coming from Siberia. Second main point, the Himalayas prevent rain-bearing monsoon clouds from escaping northwards near India. This causes rainfall in entire northern India because rain is very useful. We require that so that we can grow crops. And if we don't have rain, people can't grow the crops because in some areas water problem is there. There are dense forests up to an altitude of 1500 meter, means it has the dense forest. A rich variety of vegetation and wildlife are found in these forests. The Himalayas are the sources of major rivers like Ganga, Indus, Brahmaputra and their tributaries. These rivers make our land fertile. Because of this, cultivation is possible in this area.